Hi, I'm Brad Weil from the Go Wild team at RE/MAX. I wanted to start by giving you a recap of what happened in 2018 for the Guelph real estate market, as well as provide my predictions for 2019 and how you can capitalize on the market coming up next year. We're anticipating to end the year with approximately 2,177 sales in the city of Guelph. And if we hit that number, we'll be down about 8% from what we had in 2017. This will also be the lowest amount of sales that we've had in the city of Guelph since 2012. So the main reasons for this are one, the foreign buyer's tax, which was introduced in the beginning of January, in combination with the raising interest rates. Both of these have reduced buyers' affordability and they've taken a lot of purchasers out of the market. As far as the average sale price goes for all housing types, if we look at the entire year of 2018 compared to 2017, prices have been flat. Now, if we just look at the last quarter, the fourth quarter of 2018 compared to 2017, we're up about 3%. And condo-style apartments are the big winner. They're up 8.5%, which isn't a real surprise considering that affordability is going down. We're seeing more people purchase these lower-priced properties. The average days to sell a property in Guelph this year was 26, so that was up 30% from what we had in 2017. Another big difference that we saw this year is the amount of houses that hit the market in Guelph and successfully sold dropped from 73% in 2017 to 64% in 2018. So what are the predictions for 2019? Well, most economists are predicting for it to be a fairly moderate real estate market with not a lot of change. The Canadian Real Estate Association is actually being a bit more optimistic than others. They're predicting about a 5.3% increase in the number of sales in Ontario, as well as for prices to go up on average by 3.3%. Whereas others like CMHC are predicting for both new home starts as well as the number of sales to reduce. One thing to look out for next year is going to be interest rates. So the Bank of Canada rate is currently sitting at 1.75%, and that's after already having 5 interest rate hikes just since the summer of 2017. That's more interest rate hikes than we had seen in the previous 10-year period before that. And the Bank of Canada has said that they are going to continue to raise rates to normalize them. So that means next year they're looking at raising rates up to about 2.25% and continuing to raise them anywhere between 3 to 3.5% in 2020. This is going to start to cause some issues for some people who are going to be renewing their terms this year and next year, who had much lower interest rates 5 years ago. And for some Canadians who were already leveraging themselves, this could cause affordability issues. And we are going to continue to see mortgage rules continue to tighten in 2019. For buyers, you're going to want to make sure that you get pre-approved before you start looking. A lot of people who would have qualified for a mortgage a couple years ago are having trouble now. Also, by being pre-approved, this is going to ensure that you lock in at the current rate before they go up. As affordability continues to weaken, we're going to start to see a higher demand for lower-priced homes, such as condos and townhouses. This means for people who are looking to upsize, they are at a big advantage this year. You can sell your house in a lower-priced market where it's very hot and purchase a more expensive home in a less competitive market. This might be a tougher year for people who are thinking about downsizing and selling a larger home. If you're going to sell a more expensive house and buy a less expensive one this year, you want to make sure that you sell your house first before you purchase. And I think you're going to be better to sell your house in the first quarter of 2019 because there'll be less competition on the market and you'll be getting ahead of some of the interest rate hikes. Now, from an investor's perspective, this reduced affordability is going to mean that there's a lot of purchasers who would have previously purchased a house that are going to now decide to rent. And it's going to increase the demand for executive rentals in the Guelph marketplace. Just make sure that when you're buying your rental property and you're running your cash flow analysis, that you do account for interest rates going up in the future. If you have any questions about the Guelph real estate market, please comment below and I'd be happy to answer them for you.